Well, we know that there are big gaps in health outcomes across the city, in life expectancy, in chronic diseases, in how well people just feel. And we want to address that as a city. We know the answers are not simple. There's lots of research that's been done to try and understand it, and we know that it isn't a simple answer. But by coming together and looking at it from all different angles, we hope that we can come up with some solutions that work for Plymouth.
We could do a lot more to prevent people from experiencing ill health, particularly ill mental health. And there's a lot that we can do to make people the smaller things in people's lives better when it comes to their health. So we're looking at a wide range of issues like dentistry, mental health, perinatal support, and it all comes together to help for people to live their lives.
There's some really positive signs that things are starting to change, and we've got some initiatives in the pipeline that are already starting to yield some results. There's also been some good national news with regards to the new GP contract, which is going to allow practices and GP networks to work more flexibly moving forward, which is a really good sign.
I've been a dentist in Plymouth for over 30 years, and I feel very passionate about the situation of oral health in the city, and particularly in the most deprived areas where my practice was. And I've tried all through my career to try and influence people to change things. And now currently, with my role in Health Education England, I'm trying to bring dentists and improve oral health to the city from that direction.
We want to prevent dental disease before it occurs. We know that if it occurs, it's very expensive to treat, and there's a lack of services in the city. So my focus in particular is on prevention and working out in communities to sort of spread that message about oral health.
And I think we need to be much more focused on actually asking people what matters to them, letting them set the goals, because they're much more likely to buy into those things that's going to make a difference and change their lives 30, 40, 50 years in the future if they understand why and they're involved in that. So there's huge benefits in putting people right at the centre of that decision making.